Testing. Hello, Southeastern Michigan, Detroit, Ferndale, Royal Oak, all the peoples that are here for Chico. I've been very fortunate to meet Chico. I'm not someone that's known him for years, but finally, because he was down river and Dearborn, and he started going to the Scarab Club and going to Ann's events, and I was fortunate enough to meet him. I thought we had more in common than I thought, because I thought our birthdays were the same day, but it was my mistake. He's March 5th, I'm June 6th. But I decided to look up Chico because I wanted to know what it meant. I've never met a Chico. And something about a little boy or a little man. And my son's name is Paul, which means little. And I take that to mean when your name's like that, that you might have the vibrancy of the young. And when Chico smiles and his eyes light up, you know that he hasn't lost some of the ways that we need to keep. Now, if I can, because he said something about the 60s, and Carlos is my favorite of the living 60s musicians, but in early 70, I went to the Red Rocks concert, and the only way I could see Jimi Hendrix was to be a really great actress. Because the people I went with didn't have tickets, and it was at Red Rocks, and there's this thing that you jump over. They all jumped over. I looked down, and I looked at my short legs, and I faked an asthma attack. And the ambulance took me in, and they said, "You're fine," and I was there. So I got to see Jimi Hendrix. But the best thing was when I went back to town, and all the groupies were at the Cosmopolitan Hotel, I went over to the bus station, because I just didn't like to fight those kind of lines. And who was in there sitting in there having a cup of coffee but Jimi Hendrix and Noel Redding and the Vanilla Fudge. So my mouth was down to my knees, and Jimmy looked at me, he said, "Why don't you just come and sit with us and have some coffee?" And I said, "Oh, okay." So then on the way back to the hotel, and Denver's a little bit like a small town in some ways, like Dodge City during the days of Wyatt Earp or something, you know. And so the security came up to him and said, that he couldn't bring me up. He said, "No, you know, there's enough people up there, you can't bring her up." So he turned around, he didn't even go up there, and he told Noel Redding, he said, "I'll see you tomorrow." Got a cab, came back to my house, we smoked the weed. I tried to call and get some purple haze, but that was right before texting and all that stuff. So when I called my connect, he couldn't get back to me till the next day. But it was so, Jimi Hendrix was one of the nicest, most modest people I've ever met. He talked about astrology, talked about other people's music. He wanted us to play other people's music. And he was one of the sweetest people that I've ever met. So now my only goal is to meet Carlos and dance when he's singing like the whole entire concert. It's like going to a rainbow or something. But I just wanted to share that with Chico. And when I looked up his name, I had a horse when I was 6 years old, and the horse's name was Chico. That's the only other Chico I know. I'm not saying Chico's a horse, but horses are my favorite animals anyway. And I always even told my dog that. I said, "You're my favorite dog, but I like horses better." So, my first poem I'm going to read, I wrote in 1997, and we were working a lot on the lawn spray issue, because living in Oakland County, unless you're in Hazeltucky or Joke Park, everybody sprays their lawn because they can. And you get kind of sick of it because it's not good for you. Spring used to rekindle such stirrings, clothes on the line drying, seeds sprouting into flowers, convertibles with the top down, mild winds blowing, walking the dog, babies in baby carriages, children on swings. Now with the lawn spray conglomerates, I long for winter and shut windows to hide away from the chemical stew of spring and summer. Flowers in bloom, passions running high, people sitting on their porches enjoying the view and each other. Spring used to remind me of freedom. Now it reminds me of slavery and bondage. Spring used to bring out a gate to my walk, a breathless urgency to my talk, a feeling of hope, a looking forward to, a looking ahead. Smelling lilacs can still bring back the best of my childhood and enrapture my body and soul to the point of orgasm. But if I take too big a breath in my reverie, I wake up again to the nightmare of now, a chemical stew brought to us by the very few, for all of us, even them. Is everybody enjoying the day after the rapture party? I think on Facebook there was almost 1 million, and I think he had less. And I didn't even know about him if it wasn't for Facebook. His name is Camper, and I think he went, camping, and he's going to go camping. His website is down, and he's gone. But I don't think, I think that the whole thing was a scam.
And
only the good went up with him, the scam artist. Huh? The thing is I knew it wasn't going to happen, or I would have bought a half a gallon of chocolate instead of a pint, and I would have ate the whole thing right before 6 and made myself really sick. But I didn't believe it, and I don't know who really did, the people he scammed. This one's called Corporate Lass, or Standing in Line for What's Mine. You've had a facelift. You've had a tummy tuck. Next month it's your ass. Your children are in private school, far away. No need for much input there. Your husband is usually gone. Unless he's Arnold, then he's still at home. Oh, excuse me, I had to just do that. But expects you to be beautiful, charming, and on command. Clothes must be dry cleaned, lawn sprayed, house polished, shining inside and out. Better living through chemistry, pharmaceuticals, including you with your fine rearranged self. All sense of values gone. Shallowness and vanity prevail. Always worried it won't last. As your mind stales, your youth dries up, he finds someone younger to put through the paces of his addictions. She'll walk through the hall of the plastic surgeon soon, too. But a portion of the proceeds still goes to you, which was your greatest concern to begin with. Thank you. I'm going to try to sing a song. My voice is real raspy. I might sound like Louis Armstrong. I should be so lucky. But I'm singing this one for all the people that have had to work for the man and not get paid what they deserve. And my grandfather, who on my jacket, I found his union pin from Chevrolet Gear and Axle from the 1930s. And this song, I didn't know the Platters did it. I just thought Tennessee Ernie did it, but here we go. Some people say a man is made out of mud. A poor man's made out of muscle and blood and skin and bones, a mind that's weak and a back that's strong. You load 16 tons, and what do you get? You get another day older and deeper in debt. St. Peter, don't you call me, 'cause I can't go. I owe my soul to the company store. Do-do-do-do-do, the company store. I was born one morning when the sun didn't shine. I picked up my shovel and I went to the mine. Loaded 16 tons of number 9 coal. And the straw boss said, well, bless my soul. You load 16 tons, and what do you get? You get another day older and deeper in debt. St. Peter, don't you call me, I won't go. I owe my soul to the company store. If you see me coming, you better step aside. A lot of men didn't, and a lot of men died. My one fist is iron, the other is steel. And if the left one don't get you, then the right one will. You load 16. 16 tons. And what do you get? Another day older and deeper in debt. St. Peter, don't you call me, 'cause I can't go. I owe my soul to the company store. I was born one morning, it was drizzling rain. Fighting and trouble is my middle name. I was raised down the canebrake by an old mountain mine. And there ain't no hard-hearted women makes me walk that line. You load 16 tons, and what do you get? Another day older and deeper in debt. St. Peter, don't you call me, 'cause I can't go. I owe my soul. Company store.
Thank you.
I might do another. I don't know if my voice. I wanted to do my way. I changed a few of the words in it, but I think I'll just read another poem. Thank you. Okay, this one I wrote after I had a bad tire accident going to my shrink in Ann Arbor a long time ago. That was also in 1997. Try not to get worried. This is from Jesus Christ, though. Try not to turn on to problems that upset you. Don't you know everything's all right? Yes, everything's all right. Everything's all right, not barreling down the freeway on a hot summer June afternoon, going to Ann Arbor for therapy, vehicles all passing me by. What's their hurry? I'm wondering who needs therapy more, me or the therapist, or the whole damn world for that matter. I'm not in a particularly good mood, but not really down either, because I'm listening to one of my favorite tapes, Jesus Christ Superstar, when all of a sudden my car swerves to the right and I realize something's wrong. I'm glad I'm in the right lane. I pull off the road. I realize the song that's on is Everything's All Right. And those exact words are the last I hear as I turn off the radio and then the motor. I step outside to see the worst looking tire I've ever seen and realize that I could have been killed. So with a smile and a better mood, I realize everything really is all right, at least for now, at least for me. And I stick my thumb out, waiting for a ride to the nearest gas station, unknown as to what's next, but very hopeful sometimes, at least for now. Thank you very much.